Yo,
what's up, critiquer?
Click, click. Point of view, POV.
As much sexual content that I've heard from this album, I'm expecting this to be sexual. Point of view? You already know what I'm expecting here. Might not be, though. I could just be a dirty-minded motherfucker. But this album is called Positions, and so far it's been nasty. So, let's do this, man.
Say, that's pretty cocky as fuck. I want to see me from your point of view. Like,
I love myself.
Yeah, I love myself so much. I would love to see how much you love me in your head. Like, it's so funny.
I love to see me from your point of view. I want to trust me. Trust me. Oh, don't you trust me. Trust me.
Okay, so
yeah.
That made me think of it like she doesn't love herself as much as she sees this person loving her.
Mm-hmm.
So I get it now.
Mm-hmm.
That's pretty genius. That's genius. Ah, I love all the lyrics and that I've heard of from Position so far. The lyrics have been really good. Really good.
Couldn't believe it, see it for myself. Oh, I'm being patient, but now I'm really falling, falling, frozen, slowly falling.
Violin.
Right. I won't keep you waiting, waiting. My bag is waiting, waiting.
She added, like, it was like a choir almost.
Damn. It was like she was preaching. It was like her singing in a church or something.
I think it's basically saying that she hasn't loved herself that much until she got with this person. Mm-hmm. Because this person showed her all her beauty and all her, like he showed her that her flaws were beautiful too. Like, everything about her is beautiful from his point of view.
Right.
Don't you feel like it could also be saying, like, her past relationships made her insecure? Because they didn't love her as much as this person does.
Right.
Like, finally someone is giving her that love that she deserves. Mm. And it's making her see how much she's worthy, how much she, you know, she is worthy of that love. So this person's changing her point of view, too. Mm. Without even her asking, like, I wonder what it's like to be in your point of view. She just knows that, like, wow, he sees me up here. So, like... Mm. That's all that matters, is, like, you know, he loves me.
Yeah, like, he accepts my flaws, the flaws that I can't accept in my head. Which, that's pretty, it's cute. It's cute.
It's a healthy, very healthy relationship.
I like it. It was less sexual than I thought.
Yeah.
This is very cutesy. So this is produced by Oliver Frid, TB Hits, and Mr. Frank. So... TB Hits and Mr. Franks have been involved in every song so far. So those are her guys. So I like the lyric, "You got more than 2020, babe," because it's building off of the lyric, "It's like you got superpowers." And obviously 2020 means you got really good vision. But also 2020, everybody knows that 2020 has just been a bad year. The coronavirus has been terrible this year, and everyone talks about how 2020 is terrible. So you got more than 2020, babe. Like, you got more than what this year is. I think that's what she was trying to refer to. Like, just trying to play a joke off of how bad 2020 is. Like, 2020 of a year, it sucks.
I feel like with this part, she's saying that, you know me better than anyone else, better than even I know myself. So I know if you see me as this perfect person, you see me as my highest potential, then, like, that must be what I really am. Like, I must really be what, like, how you see me, because you know me better than anyone. You know the things that I try to hide, so you really know me.
Your point of view and how you don't even see my flaws, you look past my flaws and you see my potential and all the beautiful things about me. Like, if I could only see that, then you know, I'd be better than ever.
Like, she's saying that you don't judge me. You don't judge me for my mistakes and my flaws, but I do. I judge myself. Mm-hmm. So if I saw myself from your point of view, then I'd be able to look past all these things that I dwell on about myself that just I shouldn't even, like, focus on. They don't matter.
Right.
So I think that's another thing that she's saying, too. Mm-hmm.
And then in the second verse, she's talking about how she's somewhat scared to fall into deep love. Like, she's getting used to receiving, a lot of love, but still getting good at not leaving love that seems like it's too good. Like, it seems like it's perfect. She says, "I'm gonna love you even though I'm scared, learning to be grateful for myself." So she wants to see this point of view, like we just said. She wants to see your point of view, so she can feel more grateful for herself and not focus on her flaws, and rather focus on her strengths.
She wants to love herself to the highest potential so she can love him to the highest potential, because if she's not loving herself, she's not going to be able to give him the love that she wants to.
Right.
Right, so if he fixes her not loving herself, then this relationship can be okay. She doesn't have to be scared. She'll know that this is right. So that's what I think that's what she's saying overall.
Oh, look, she actually talked about this song on the Zach Sang show. She says, of course you love yourself before you're able to fully love someone else, of course. And this isn't really about that. It's just kind of about, you know, how everyone has the little things that they're like, ugh, how could you like that? And you see someone who you're madly in love with love that, and you're just like, I'm floored. It's like, oof, I want to feel that. So, like we were saying, looking past my little imperfections, and I just want to see from your point of view how you could love everything about me and not focus on these terrible things about me.
And maybe even like the things that she doesn't like about herself. Like, maybe right. He really likes them.
Right. So I would say this is probably about her new boyfriend. She really likes this guy. Hopefully she stays with this guy.
She's making it a point to say that she's scared to love again, but that this guy is worth it. This guy makes it feel like it's worth it.
Right.
So that's awesome.
So this is written by Mr. Franks, TB Hits, Taylor Parks, Oliver Freed, and Ari. Also, Ari said here, I adore Taylor. I love writing with her. Creating with her is so special.
Yeah, I don't remember. I don't know how many albums Taylor and Victoria worked on with her, but I know that the last two, I think. What was that album called? Thank You Next. I know they definitely worked with her on Thank You Next, because I remember that whole interview on Zach Sang when she talked about it. About how these girls were like her rocks when she was going through it with Mac and everything that was going on that year. She had them to really help her like get through and write these songs to get through it. So she really cares and loves about her team and these people that help her write. Like, they're her family, they're her friends. So that's really nice.
Yeah, it must be nice to have good friends to write with instead of people that, you know, you don't really like or disagree with that. Want to control your work, you know what I mean? Like, it's clear that she has people that she enjoys around her that she creates with, rather than
just some like strangers that are about the money.
Like a company person that just wants to put their views on you.
It's very lovey, like a nice love song.
It's cute. So, more Ariana Grande positions on the way. You guys let me know what's next. It's been a great album so far.
Mm-hmm.
Not a single track that I can say sounds bad. I don't think that's going to happen here. That doesn't really happen with Ariana.
Nope.
You're never like, ew, her voice sounds disgusting. That doesn't happen with Ariana Grande.
No.
It's almost like, damn, like, tone it down. Let someone else have a chance to sound this good. You know? That's how I feel when I listen to Ari. Like, damn. But thank you guys so much for critiquing with us. If you like this video, we appreciate if you give this video a like. Stay tuned for some more positions. Got to finish this album out, so make sure you click subscribe to become part of the click. So you stay tuned and stay breezy and classy. And everything else that you should stay. You know where you should stay. Critic out.
Shout out.